Don't place a trade based on what you're seeing in this video, because there is no guarantees of making a profit in the market. It takes you a long time to become a good trader. So this video here is just to educate you to become a much better trader. Hey traders, happy Monday or Sunday, wherever you guys are across the globe. Today we are going to be getting into the S&P 500, the Nasdaq, the Dow. We'll be looking at the gold minings as well too, silver, gold. Also going to be looking at some really interesting reports that I've been reading just recently. And about how a guy lost $700,000, a 20-year-old who lost $700,000 trading these markets. Absolutely crazy. And you know, it's just, yeah, just nuts. And I'm also gonna be talking about the good old CV, 19, you know what I'm talking about. I just can't say the word here on the good old YouTubes. But yeah, we're gonna be talking more about that and what that's gonna mean to the markets moving forward. So let's actually start with the stock market first, okay? Let's start with the technicals and I'll get into some of the fundamental things that I'm seeing right now. Now, the first thing that I am seeing right now, and the right now we can see that we've had a very big sharp move to the upside, okay? Now, if I bring up, say, this chart here for a minute, and I bring up, say, 1 year worth of data, all right, it gives me a really good time. We can see we had a nice move up sideways and then a very nice move up, a bit of a gap up through here. And this is called an island reversal, where it gaps up sideways and then a bit of a gap down. Now we do have what I see happening right now is I see probably a retracement down to at least that 2,800 level. There's that major level of support level through here. So I do see that it's probably likely to come back down. We have a bit of a gap here to be filled. So I believe we're likely to fill that gap. Now, they always say that gaps always get filled. It's really, really, it's interesting to see how if this gap up here gets filled and whether these gaps here get filled, because not all the time they get filled. Now, especially in this market here, right, we've now created the new era in this market. So I always saw every single gap here in the S&P gets filled. Most of the time they do, but maybe it's going to take 3 or 5 years for this thing to get filled up here. I don't know. But what we're looking at here right now, guys, is a very big move up and then a gap up going sideways and then a gap down, okay? So that's an island reversal technicals. And then if we bring up the good old trend line through there, we can actually see, let me bring it up through there. And the reason why I'm drawing it through there, all right, is because I'm getting the close instead of the wick, okay? The close is or the lows of the open and closes are the most important parts. So as you can see what happened here, right? We ran up, bit of a stretch, gap down, and look what happened today, right? Or look what happened on Friday last week. We went up. If I go to my hourly chart, you'll be able to see this even more. You can see I gapped up, hit that level of resistance, and actually rejected off it. Look at that massive island reversal through there. Man, I wish I was trading the futures market at that time, because the futures market would have looked amazing. In fact, let me actually bring up the futures chart right now. The futures chart would have created a massive rounding top pattern. I've talked about this before in other videos, but when the market starts to be overstretched and then we start to create this rounding, sort of a flattening action, and then we start to drop, it's a really, 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 really good opportunity to be going, to be short in the markets. And this actually, I saw this actually happening in, let me, before I get to bring up the futures, let me bring up Apple. This is actually what, this see here with Apple, whenever the market does this, guys, okay, whenever the market does this, and how to qualify this even more, let me bring up, all right, I'll just keep that there, right? So as you can see here, look at this back here. Notice how when we have a big move up and then we start to sort of flatten out, we're overstretched and then we're flattening out. We're due for some sort of a pullback, right? So it doesn't mean the overall trend has changed, because it actually didn't. We actually had just a, what happened with Apple? We did get the drop, right? But then it continued this upward trend. But looking at the futures level, we can see that we actually had a big movement through there, right? So, you know, guys, one of the most important things to you is having a good trading system, learning how to read the charts, and so much more when it comes to your trading, you know what I mean? So that's what I want. That's what I'm seeing through there when it comes to that rounding top there. And once again, guys, the most important thing you do is really get a good handle on how to read these markets, read these charts, and so much more. Guys, I'm giving away a free trial to my Master Trader Lab. We're going to get access to my top foundations, chart reading, two amazing trading systems, my seven-figure secrets. I put up brand new trainings every single week, and I do a live coaching brand new trainings every month, and I also do a live monthly coaching session every month as well too, and I'm giving away a free trial to that. Very first link in the description, or just go to mastertraderlab.com and you'll be able to activate your free trial to that right now. Start learning all the techniques, start learning what you need to know about these markets, and start to learn that the foundations, the chart reading strategies, have some good trading systems there. And every single month you're releasing new trainings, and every single month I'm gonna be doing live coaching sessions to help you out. So go to mastertraderlab.com, or the very first thing in the description, go click on that and go activate your free trial right now to that. And I look forward to seeing you in the membership area. And by the way, you'll be able to see, I just did my recent coaching session last week as I'm doing this video. So you'll be able to see what I talked about, what I did on that coaching session when you log in to that as well too. Now, as I was saying before, based on the futures market here, let me bring this up through here. So let me just bring this up, this chart up through here. This is the futures market here. And this is why, guys, I love reading charts. Charts are always giving you a good sign. Well, what's going on right now? What's going on? You know, and one of the best things I can say, guys, is the better you can read the chart, the better trader you will be. Look at this here right now, guys. Look at this massive. Now, this is the futures market. This is why I just wish I was trading the futures at that time. But I'd no longer trade the futures because I don't need to. I just trade 1 hour per day for myself. And then I try to focus on the other things that gives me happiness and so on and so forth in the market. Because guys, for me, I've been doing this now for 15 years myself. And so it's a bit of repetitive myself. Like, I'm looking for the same thing day in, day out. Nothing really changes, right? But look at this here, right? We actually have a shoulder, a head, a shoulder formation. But look what happened here, right? This is where you can start to see a bit of a rounding top formation. Now this rounding top was where? That was basically the island reversal, right, on the cash market. Now we're looking at the futures market, but the cash market did what? The cash market had a gap here and also had a gap here. But look what was happening through here. As soon as we actually broke this neckline, let's actually bring this neckline. It's probably through there somewhere, right through there, yeah. So we're probably looking at somewhere through there. Look at this here, shoulder. And this is where the market's always talking to us, isn't it? Look at this here, we had a low, we had a higher low, we had a high, we had a higher low, some sort of lower high through there, came down, lower low, lower high. Look what happened here. Notice how the market started to, we had a little lower low and lower high through there as well too, bit of an equal high. But notice how the market started to go from stair stepping up to now stair stepping down, right? See, now a lower high, breaking the lows. And look what happened here with big fall. When was that? That was after the market giving us a massive head and shoulder formation. So the technicals are, once we start to learn technicals, right? That's the most important thing that we can do, is start to really look at the technicals when we're looking at the markets through there. So back onto the Dow Jones, with what we're seeing through here, I believe that this major resistance level here on the Dow Jones, as you can see, this 27,000 level has been a major resistance level to it. I really thought that was going to happen. I originally actually had a 27,000 target on the Dow, but when we got to 24,000 and we struggled, I thought, well, maybe we're not going to get there, because I actually had, for me personally, I had call options. And I bought some call options here, and they were a losing position. And then when the market really started to tank, I loaded up big time and then sold all my options through here and collected really nice profits. And then the market continued up from there. But looking at the Dow Jones right now, we can see how we've had this major level of resistance through here. And you can see what happened. We stretched, gap up, gap down, and where we are right now. And if I draw my trend line through here, we can actually see, once again, I'm going to draw it through there. I'm going to draw it, try to get the most sort of open and closes through there, I would say. And you can see what happened here on the Dow Jones, right? Let me bring up the hourly chart. Again, a little gap up, finding a little bit of resistance through there as well too. So it'd be really interesting to see. Actually, the trend line's probably through there somewhere, I would say. It's probably through there. The reason why is because I'm picking up more of the more of these lows through here. I'm trying to get more touches. When I'm drawing my trend lines, I'm trying to get more touches through here. Then we have a breakdown, market rallies up, rejects through there, and we come down through there. So on the Dow Jones, I know that I was looking at the S&P just a minute ago, but on the Dow Jones, this sort of level through here, which would be the level that I see it actually dropping down to. I don't believe we're going to get down to the new lows, but we may. Especially what I'm going to talk about here when it comes to the fundamental side of things. S&P 500, same sort of thing. I believe we're going to get down to around about that 2800, probably on the SPY. We can see that the 38% and down even to 50% is around the 270 level mark. We do have a lot of level of support around this whole level. This whole area through here is a major level of support. So once we do get there, guys, if anyone's in options or anyone's in a short position, then that'll be the time I would say to look to exit the position if you are in a trade. I'm neither confirm or deny that if I am in some put options right now. But we can see that that's what's going on through there, and that's what I see what's happening right now. And so we may just get a pullback here, guys, and it may continue up in a big bull market. Either way, we're likely to get the pullback here, and that's what I see there on a short-term basis. And same for the NASDAQ. The NASDAQ, once again, look at the NASDAQ. The NASDAQ level there, and let me bring this up even more. Right, there we go, from there to there. Look at this here, big gap up. We broke above new highs, and then we actually gapped down. And then we had a little sideways bar through this. So I do see, probably likely to see more selling coming into this week. And it's a very, very, very exciting week moving forward. Now, moving on now, guys, through to the whole fundamentals of what's going on right now, is that we can see that if I bring up this, let me just bring this whole thing up here. We can see that this article here on Zero Hedge talked about the market corrects as the COVID surges, in the bear market is still valid. Now, if the market did sell off because of new, quote unquote, new cases coming into play, then that's actually not a really good sign for a long-term bull. And the reason why I'm saying that is because of this. If that's what's happening right now, guys, we know, right? We know. Like, even if it does die down right now, we know there's going to be a massive surge that's going to come towards the end of this year again, right? Especially in America, right? Why? Because we're going to start get back into the winter season again, right? The flu season. So if that's the case and we go through another major sort of, if the market's corrected the way it is right now, just from a surge in new cases, then I'd hate to see what happens when it really fully erupts again, which it's going to happen, right? This is not a wham bam thank you ma'am, it's all done and dusted. By the end of this year, guys, even if it does die down, over the next few months, by the end of this year, we're going to get another massive surge of it supposedly peering its head. It's still disappeared, and stuff like that. So that is actually not looking good for the bull market long term, which I don't believe we're going to enter the bull market long term. And that's the reason why Warren Buffett and some other really important, really successful long term investors are not either A, selling their stock, and B, not buying any stock right now. Like Warren Buffett is doing. He's not stupid. He's not dumb. He knows what's likely to happen over the next probably 2 or 3 years. And then over that time, I'm probably likely to be a really good buying opportunity as well too. But here's one thing I want to talk about here, guys, when you are trading the market. Here is an article here on finance is not worth losing your life over. Family tragedy should be lessons for all. Robin Hooders. Presented with a little comment as Frank, it speaks for itself. This article here, look at this here, okay? This is still raw, and I have more questions than answers. But it's very important in instincts of what I speak about here. Hopefully my family's tragedy can help another's family's tragedy. My cousin-in-law was interested in investing. He opened a Robinhood account and he seemed to be enjoying the markets, as many of us do, and have got interested in options. Very, very, very. He believes he had no margin selected on his account. So he began buying and selling options. Guys, that's a very, very, very... Buying options, yes. Because when you buy options, guys, that's why I love buying options. Because the maximum I can lose is what I'm in the market. Even if I have 20% of my account in one position, that's the maximum I can lose. I can't lose a lot more. That's why I love buying options. Selling options is a very, very, very risky strategy. And the long term, it's not really a good... it may be for really, really, really large investors who know they definitely want to buy a certain stock at a certain price. So yes, selling options at that price would be, you know, it's like, okay, well, if Facebook drops 10%, I'm happy to buy it at that price. That's where I'm happy to buy it. So selling options there, but that's much larger, okay? Much, much larger investors. But for the average retail investor, don't be selling options. Why? Because like what he says here, right? Let's actually move this up through here. Let's zoom in here a bit more. He says, fast forward to sometime this past week and his account showed him owing $700,000. He does, how does a 20-year-old with no income get access to that sort of exposure? That's crazy, right? Absolutely crazy. So guys, if you guys don't think we're at the top of the market right now, with one massive amount of people entering the market. If I go to this article through here right now, this is actually about, you know, Fortnite. 10-year-olds are now not playing Fortnite because they're day trading. Crazy, right? Spike, a record number of spiked people entering the market when most people are greedy, be fearful, you know. And then obviously look at this here. To this, we cannot add the recent trends for Robinhood, which predictably is also at all time high. Look at people in Robinhood right now. I've heard Robinhood just being really, really, really bad. Okay, so guys, please, there is no shortcut to this here, guys. Use a predictable broker. For me personally, I like using Interactive Brokers because they're not a very quick, you know, they've got so much restriction or so much security behind it as well too, and so on and so forth. But let's actually continue here with this article through here. So the emotional stress from the exposure caused him to take his own life. Absolutely crazy, guys, okay? I don't feel right sharing this, but I also don't feel right keeping it from the world. Why? Because recently I've been joking around about how much I love the DGG. I've been laughing at the Robin memes. But here's the truth. Please pay attention to this if you are young. The markets are bananas right now. It's not the time for amateurs. Really, really pay attention to position sizing. Stay away from exotic instruments like options and futures. I wouldn't say that. All I would say is if you're going to trade futures, make sure you definitely have a stop in place and don't leave it. If you're trading short term, like 1 minute charts and so on and so forth, what I've learned by trading those markets and trading those instruments is that one, have a stop in place, and two, always have one or at least two. Or at least one, but preferably two internet backups, right? And so that's what I do personally. So I actually have, for me personally, what I do is with my trading, I use Interactive Brokers, and even when I'm doing my trading, I have my internet connection at home, which most of my trading is done. Then I have a broadband stick that I can plug into my laptop, or at least even just have the broadband stick and plug it in my desktop, and I can activate it through there. And last but least, I can hop onto my phone and then log in through the app trader to see my positions and activate and execute and so on and so forth. In fact, recently I actually had to do that. Recently, the Interactive Brokers platform went down, which 99% of the time it's good, and I've been using it for years and years and years. But for some reason, I couldn't log into the Interactive Brokers trading platform. So all I did is just open up my phone, click, because I already had the app there, log in, put my details there, and I was logged in straight away, and I could get out of position that I wanted to get out of with no hassles. And also I could enter a position as well too, no hassles as well too. So that's all I say. If you're going to trade the futures market, firstly, understand whenever you have a stop in place, understand that risk there, okay? And that risk should never be more than, say, a couple percent on your account. And options are really, really good because not selling options, as I was saying before, don't be selling options, because that's how I believe he got $700,000 in loss, because I believe he was looking at, oh my goodness, I can sell these options and make all this money. All he was probably seeing was all the money he was bringing into the account, without even having to pay anything. It's like, oh, this is easy money. I'm making all this money and don't even have to do anything. And then something, obviously, when things go really wrong, that's when he can just really, 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 really be in big trouble, right? And before you know it, you just made $20,000 in income from the options, but now you owe $400,000, and now if the market goes against you, you now have to buy the stock for $400,000, and maybe you don't even have that in the account. So we can see that through there, guys. And he said here, the market's up in the bananas right now. It's not the time for amateurs. Really, really, really pay attention to position sizes, especially options. And again, options, that's the reason why my number one strategy is buying options for the risk, because my risk is only what I can put in there. The upside, I can make 200%, 300%, 400%, 500% return, 1,000% return. And then also my maximum risk is what I actually put in the market any given time. So if the whole world goes belly up, guess what? And I've got, say, 10% of my account in the market, that's the maximum I can lose. That gives me that sleep at night factor. And I absolutely love that. There are the times Warren Buffett talks about being more careful than others. It's probably right now. Almost everything you see on this platform is coming from someone else with a bias, myself included, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. I do have to ask if you know any Robinhood's willing to extend my credit, et cetera, et cetera. Rest in peace. There we go. All right. So that's what I wanted to share with you here, guys, is that with this article through here, we can see how people are really starting to do some damage here, right? They really are starting to do some damage with their account and so on and so forth. So guys, this is not the characteristics of a next bull market. This is the characteristics of a topping pattern, of a major topping pattern. And I truly believe that everything we're seeing right now is, you know, people are massive bullish right now. People are just massive bullish right now, and people are just let me just show you this here. I truly believe, guys, that when we look at this chart through here, and we look at the overall markets where we are right now, I truly believe we have just come off the big major crash through here. This is obviously the psychology of the markets. I showed a different chart of this before World War II, but I honestly truly believe that we have just seen something. We have just seen this move up through here. Complacency. We just need to cool off for the next rally, right? We've been through this. We've been through euphoria. What is euphoria? Like the euphoria. Am I saying that word right? Euphoria. Look at this here. If this is not, if let me bring up, say, the Dow Jones, and let me bring up, say, the weekly chart here for a minute. Let me look at this here. I want to share something with you here. Notice how we ran up, went sideways, and then ran up again. I believe this last little push, hooray, was the euphoria. Let me actually bring this chart up through here so we can see it. Okay, let me bring this here. All right, let's just zoom into this bit here. Right, so we have what? We have the push up. So what do we have here? We have the euphoria here. I believe this was the euphoria here. Big first crash. Now we've had the rally through here. Everything looks pretty good. Now we've had this big rally through here. Everything looks pretty good. And now I believe we're getting ready for something like this as well too. So, guys, it's really, 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 but on the flip side of that, it's a really exciting time, because if you can see what's happening right now, you can really start to take advantage of it. You know, like just by looking at, say, even the weekly charts here on the candlestick patterns, we're starting to get some really, really, really bearish patterns as well too when it comes to that. So we can see we're having a very big engulfing pattern through here, and we had a big move up. Now we're getting a bearish engulfing alongside with what? This is a weekly chart on a bearish engulfing, and then on the long side on the daily charts are giving us what? Giving us that nice island reversal there. So everything, guys, fundamentally and technically, guys, is screaming more downside to come. Again, I don't believe we're going to see a massive crash out of this here, but I do believe we're likely to start to see some sort of significant pullback. If we have a look once again, let me squeeze this chart up here for a minute. Let's go back to that daily chart. I do believe that the S&P 500 is probably going to get down to the bottom through here. I would say that level through there, around that 2,800 level, guys, is probably where we're likely to pull back to, at least on a short-term basis. And that's what we're seeing through there. Now, guys, let's have a quick look at silver and gold right now. We can see that gold has continued to be doing nothing, just resting through here. That's actually a very... Let me just bring this chart up through here. I like looking at just a blank chart. The reason why I like looking at a blank chart, guys, because sometimes I'm... the technical analysis that I use is small picture, big picture. Small picture is I'm looking at, you know, the candlesticks, the highs and lows through here. And but then the big picture, I'm looking at sort of the last sort of year and see, okay, where are we in sort of the what we call the phases. And when you log into the Master Trader Lab, you can get a free trial with the link below. You know, when you log in that there, you'll be able to understand what I call a concept called price and time, and when the market needs a rest and building energy, and that's what we're doing right now. So this is actually a very, very bullish sign when it comes to that. Now, the one chart that I do want to share with you when it comes to gold is this chart through here. Look at this chart through here. We can see here that this, the blue line, all right, the blue line through here is obviously the money supply, and then obviously the red line is the gold price through here. And we could see, look at this, isn't this interesting? It seems like gold always comes back to where money supply is always happening, right? So if gold gets too far away from it, on the downside, we end up coming back towards it. If it gets too far above it, we end up coming back down. Now look what's happening, right? We're right in line. We're actually with it right now, but we're right in line with it right now. So the question is that this is where gold is and this is where the money supply is. The question is, do we actually continue to see that rally? I truly believe we're going to, based on a technical basis as well too, just based on this chart through here. I definitely do see we're probably likely to start to see a very, very nice move up when it comes to gold through there. So gold has definitely got this all-time sort of resistance. We're sort of stuck at that resistance point right now. You can see there. So it's not a coincidence, guys. If we have a look at this level through here, it's not a coincidence that we're finding a lot of sort of resistance through here right now. Why? Because he had a big run up and just hit this. Look at this here, hit that major level of resistance all through there. And now, once we break this level here, guys, we're probably on our way up to all-time new highs for the gold. And I also truly believe that silver is going to do the same thing as well too, or not all-time new highs, but once we start to break, especially that $20 level there, guys, that 20, maybe even a bit lower, that major level through there is that sort of $19, a major, major level going back over time through there. So I would say that that's definitely going to be a significant level through there. We definitely see there's major resistance and support going on around that $16 level as well too. We broke that. We broke back above it, as you can see. You can see we actually broke back above it. We're squeezing up into this triangle pattern right now when it comes to silver. So I truly believe we're likely to see a very nice breakout. Even if we do get a bit of a drop to the downside, it's probably likely to be short-lived. But silver's looking really, really exciting through there. Quick look at the GDXJ. And the GDXJ is doing pretty much nothing. We're still continuing this pullback. If you guys have been watching me now for the last month, you know I've been saying wait for a pullback, wait for a pullback, wait for a pullback, and we're starting to slowly get a pullback. I believe we're likely to get some more of a pullback. And if the stock market corrects and stock market goes down soon, then or down this week, then I believe probably the GDX and GDX, the GDXJ will probably likely to go in sync with it. But it's the GDX and GDXJ, same with the SIL and the SI, the same for the SIL and the SILJ. I believe all these mining indices, not all the gold mining stocks and not all the silver mining stocks. I'm just talking about the GDXJ, GDX, GDXJ, SIL, SILJ, them only, not all the gold mining stocks. So if you go buy a gold mining stock based on what I just said there, guys, this analysis doesn't apply to the individual gold mining stock, okay? I truly believe, once again, guys, even if we do get a bit of a pullback, we have just started a very nice bull trend. So even if the market does go through a bit of a down period through here, guys, I truly believe we're likely that even though the stock market continues down through there, I truly believe we have just this high up here and this low through here. We've made a higher high. I truly believe we're going to create a higher low, and then we've just and then we're going to continue or start this big bull run or a very nice bull run out of the GDX. Now, look at our weekly chart here, by the way, guys. Okay, so it takes time. Because we've been doing nothing and now we've got a low, I believe we're going to probably get a pullback with the overall stock market, and then a big, 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 big boost up is coming in the markets as well too. So there we go, guys. There's your update for the day. There's an update for the week as well too. It's going to be an amazing week ahead.